Once your room analysis is complete, proceed by opening the ARC 3 plugin in your favorite DAW. The correction plugin should be inserted on the stereo master bus or, when available, on the monitoring bus of your DAW. The ARC 3 correction plugin should always be the last plugin in the chain on either bus. If you use master bus processing like EQ, compression, limiting, and so on, make sure the ARC 3 plugin always comes after those. And unless ARC is placed on the monitoring bus, remember to always switch off the ARC 3 plugin before exporting the project from the DAW. Once inserted, click on the Measurements menu to load one of your previously saved measurement sets. Room measurements taken with ARC 1 or ARC 2 are not compatible with ARC 3. The advanced algorithm in ARC 3 needs more information about the room acoustics than were captured by the ARC 1 or 2 measurement process. In the play window, you can observe the green before curves and orange after curves on the graph to see how the correction filter has intervened. Take some time to listen to familiar material to adapt your ears to the new balance. The system is now more reliable and will translate everywhere properly. The real-time spectrum analyzer shows how your room was affecting the music before correction. If you experience a level decrease after inserting ARC, this is normal. ARC 3 may need to boost frequencies where the room is attenuating the sound, so the overall signal is lowered to ensure enough headroom for ARC 3 to apply the maximum possible boost, 12 dB, without clipping. The trim knob is where this attenuation takes place and can be adjusted. This control is positioned by default to keep all signals out of the red. To avoid clipping, try not to push it further than necessary. The ARC 3 correction plugin can work in two phase modes, natural and linear. Natural mode improves the phase response of the system in the room to make it more coherent between left and right channels. This helps stereo imaging, recovering the correct phantom center image even at low frequencies. Natural is the most commonly used setting, and it's perfect for rooms where the acoustics are not ideal, like most project studios, typical small mixing rooms, and similar spaces. However, in high-quality rooms with good acoustics, linear mode might be preferred, as it leaves the original phase response of your system unaltered. This can be preferable in rooms with minimal acoustic issues and great speakers, where the ARC system is only applying broad and gentle adjustments to the overall balance and not called on to fix severe acoustic issues. Another interesting feature of the ARC 3 plugin is the virtual monitoring, which is useful for auditioning how your mix will translate through several real-world devices, like TVs and car audio systems, as well as many popular studio monitors. Selecting one of the options from the drop-down menu, you will notice how the after curves change on the graph. Now the sound you hear will be like mixing with different speakers, but still in a transparent and balanced room. By default, ARC 3 applies correction to the entire 20 Hz to 20 kHz range. However, from the edit window, you're able to define range boundaries for the correction. For example, you can apply correction just to your most problematic areas, like the 20 to 300 Hz low frequencies, while excluding all the other frequencies from the correction. This allows you to address your most problematic acoustic issues while maintaining the unique voice that your monitors have in the room. This can be useful when you're particularly used to certain aspects of your monitoring and don't want to change this, or not immediately. It's also possible to tweak the response of your system to match your taste by adjusting the 6 breakpoints on the graphic. This tool is not an equalizer superimposed on the correction, as that could cause phase issues. You're directly adjusting the actual correction filter, which is recalculated after any edit to match the new target curve in the place of the flat one. You may notice a spinning wheel after making changes. This is normal as the system recalculates the correction filter. From this same window, you can also adjust the correction type. Sharp is useful in rooms with problematic low end, as the narrower bands can better fix each resonant mode. However, in high-quality rooms, where such detailed intervention is not needed, the broad mode offers a gentler action. The default mode is an in-between setting that's well-balanced in most rooms as a starting point. We recommend carefully auditioning the system with familiar material while switching among these three settings to find out which one is the most suitable for your particular room or fits with your personal listening preference. All your target curve customizations can be saved in four different custom curve slots and easily recalled from the target drop-down menu. In the metering section of the plugin, you can use several high-quality metering options derived from T-Rex 5. These are very useful, since when you insert the ARC3 plugin on the master bus, your DAW's metering will only show the corrected signal that's sent to the speakers, not the actual pre-ARC levels from your program that will eventually be exported. When set to pre, ARC3's metering lets you finely monitor the incoming signal using peak, RMS, and loudness (LUFS) modes, as well as dynamic range for a comprehensive view of your audio program. ARC System 3, a new dimension of acoustic correction.